Hello and welcome back to the PopcornFX channel. In this tutorial, we'll be showing you how to use the alpha remapper. This is actually a really amazing feature in PopcornFX that not many know about, and we're going to be giving you the insights on how to use it. This is an example that we're going to use that can be downloaded from the Popcorn Online packages. And we'll start by explaining how the alpha remapper works by going to the PopcornFX board. To use the alpha remapper, we need two things: a texture with transparency, which will be this gear. It's a normal PNG texture with different transparency values. We turned on the black layer just to show you that there are some pixels that are a bit transparent. And the second thing that we need is a texture to remap the transparency values. We'll start with this one. It's just a simple gradient, and this is how PopcornFX interprets it. Vertically going from top to bottom, it's the life ratio of the particle by default. And you can assign a cursor in PopcornFX to choose where you want to set it. And horizontally, from left to right, it's the opaqueness values to be remapped that go from 0 opaque to 100% opaque. And white remaps the opaqueness values to 100, and black remaps it to 0. So if we're using this texture as a remap, for example, along the life ratio, nothing is going to change because it's the same. So the textured parts that has 0% opaqueness, meaning fully transparent, are remapped to transparent since we're using black. Over here, we have a gray color in between black and white, meaning that the parts that are half opaque will be half opaque. And finally, the pixels in the gear texture that have 100% opaque values have a white color, meaning that the opaque part of the gear texture will be 100% opaque. We'll give more examples in PopcornFX. The no remap layer is to show you the simple gear in action. As you can see, there is no alpha remapper. Then we'll just hide the other layers to show you the differences, and turn on the no remap and the identity remap layers. We can see that this billboard has an alpha remapper texture. And if you want to see the texture in the specialized node editor, we'll click on the checkers icon and choose the second one. This is the texture that we were talking about earlier. Let's change it to a white texture, meaning that we'll remap the range of opaqueness to opaque. That means we're going to get an opaque square. If we try black, we'll get a transparent one. And if we try half black and half white, we'll get half transparent square. And of course, we would never use that in an actual effect. We're just trying to explain how the alpha remapper works. And if we try a texture with a mix of black, white, and gray, we'll get this. The part of the texture that goes from 0 to 25% opaqueness will be transparent. The part of the texture that goes from 25 to 75% opaqueness will be half transparent, as we can see in the texture. And the parts of the texture that have 75% and more opaqueness will be fully opaque. We can try another texture that follows the same logic. Here we go. Next, we're going to choose another one that changes along the life ratio. By default, the alpha cursor field is the life ratio. And here, it's going from top to bottom, remapping the transparency depending on the gradients. The beginning is the first fourth, then the second fourth, then the third fourth. As you can see, in the third fourth, the transparent values are turned opaque, and the fully opaque ones are turned fully transparent. And here's some sweet info. Since PopcornFX is pretty dynamic, it lets us change the cursor, so it doesn't have to be the life ratio. So to change that, we go to the alpha cursor field and add a variable called AR. Then add it to the fields as a float variable. Then create an evolver script if there isn't one. And if it exists already, you can choose where to set the alpha cursor field. But first, let's unpause the effect and set the AR to 0.1. If we choose a value between 0 and 0.25, it'll be choosing this part of the alpha remap texture. And if we choose a value between 0.25 and 0.5, we'll be choosing the second fourth of the remap texture. And if we choose a value between 0.5 and 0.75, it'll be this one. And finally, if we choose a value above 0.75, it'll be this one. We can even sample it to a curve and choose the way we want the remapping to happen. So we sample the curve depending on the life ratio, then change the points of the curve, and maybe add more points depending on what we want. Let's move on to the uniform dissolve. It has this visual effect. We notice the texture dissolving away. As the life ratio grows, the more transparent pixels we'll have because of the amount of black that spreads horizontally. And by the end, they are all transparent. The steep dissolve is a bit different, we'll notice that in the texture. There is more white by the end of the horizontal rows, which results in the steep dissolve. Let me unhide the steep dissolve layer so you can see the difference. And finally, the alpha sweep, that sets the full opacity to the pixels with lower opaqueness in the beginning of the life ratio to the ones that are fully opaque at the end of it. Also note that the pixels that are 0% opaque are still set to transparent in this texture. You'll just have to zoom in to see it. And now we'll move to another set of examples and ideas that can be used with the alpha remapper. Here, we have a texture of stylized fire. Basically, shapes with vertical linear transparency to animate them as shown in the editor. Very stylized fire. We're going to readjust the workspace really quick. Then we're going to use the same texture but with a slight adjustment. We can already see the difference. And if you slow down the simulation speed, it looks as if they were animated. There's a big difference between the two, and what I did was smudge the alpha along with the texture. That gave it this animated looking effect. Let's move on along to the next effect. Change the texture to fire _02A. And then change the alpha remapper texture. We'll see the different effects it can have. With the alpha remap dissolve too. Then the alpha remap dissolve. And finally the alpha remap 3. That gives this really stylized sci-fi look. You can also use the alpha remapper for HUD and GUI animations, such as life, energy, and power. Here we have an atlas texture with an attribute sampler set to change the alpha cursor and the texture ID. This one can be used to show the life points in an HUD. The colors are inverted though. Let's correct that really quick by removing the 1- before the alpha remaps in the color. And here we go. Let's test them out to give you an idea on what can be done. Different textures and different animations. This can be really powerful if used well. Let's move to the next effect. We can create cartoon animated looking textures. It's the same idea as the fire, using this alpha remap. Moving along. This can also be used for loading icons. This is a simple square texture with different levels of opacity. We can also choose to change the remap texture. And I really like this one. And finally, this is a nice trick. You can have different textures on top of each other, forming different layers of transparency. And then we set the alpha cursor to choose which one of these textures we want to show. Of course, this trick can only be used in specific situations. Well, this brings us to the end of this video. If you have any questions or ideas on how to use the alpha remapper, don't hesitate to let us know in the comments below. And as always, don't forget to like and share this video if you found it helpful, and subscribe for more videos and tutorials. And we'll see you all very soon in our next video. Thank you for watching.